are back, ladies and gentlemen, from the break on the hottest show in the streets for Alabama football news, notes, and information. I'm yours truly, Stephen Smith of Touchdown Alabama Magazine, live in studios. This is In My Own Words, and after discussing Plan B, when you look at Crimson Tide quarterbacks, the backups behind Tua Tagovailoa, we're about to jump into topic two of the conversation. But prior to that, people, you know what time it is. We are inside of 60 days before the return of the college football season, Alabama's football season. Fall camp inching closer. Southeastern Conference Media Days are a couple of weeks away. And you want to be in the know for all things Alabama football. You want the number one source, the primary stop shop. You want to be inside the information for your Crimson Tide. If Nick Saban was to sneeze right now, you don't want to be left out. How can you not be left out? Download the Touchdown Alabama Magazine app. Get that right now. Treat yourself right. Do the right thing here. You can get this from the iPhone App Store if you're rocking Team Apple, Google Play Store if you got the Android phone. Subscribe also to tdalabamamag.com. Get all the latest, and also follow the site on YouTube, Touchdown Alabama Magazine on YouTube, for all the cutting edge shows, whether it be In My Own Words or The Process, the recruiting show with our own Justin Smith, keeping you in the loop on your Crimson Tide, the site that's got over 1 million video views. But now, diving into part two of the conversation for this week, and it's Alabama's wide receiving unit, more importantly, these second-tier guys. We already know what to expect from Jerry Jeudy, Henry Ruggs, Devonta Smith, and Jalen Waddle. Jerry Jeudy, the 1,000-yard weapon from a season ago, Fred Biletnikoff Award winner, consensus All-American, somebody that you have quite a few NFL scouts that have Tua Tagovailoa being the number one overall pick in next year's draft. You have others that got Jerry Jeudy in that spot. Henry Ruggs, we know him as Mr. Toughness, Mr. Elevation, Mr. Go Get It, but also Mr. Speed, Speed, Speed. That being Henry Ruggs, Devonta Smith, Mr. Clutch, Mr. Vertical Deep Threat Wide Receiver, and then Jalen Waddle, Mr. Explosion, Mr. Electricity, the Cheetah, getting up and down the field. So those four guys, we know those guys. But the second tier is what we're about to get into. And of that second tier, I want to pull out Xavier Williams. I want to pull out Ziggy for a moment. Xavier Williams at 6'1", 195 pounds, the redshirt freshman out of Hollywood. Not California, the other Hollywood, Hollywood, Florida, came out of Chaminade Madonna Prep School. And here's a guy that, for Alabama, Nick Saban has had great fortune in recruiting guys from all 50 states. He's recruited guys from Alabama, Mississippi, Georgia, California, Texas, Tennessee, Kentucky. In recent years, he's gone up to New Jersey and pulled guys. He's pulled guys from Maryland. So Nick Saban has been all over the map. He likes that manifest destiny, conquering from east to west, pulling guys from everywhere. But when it comes down to getting a game-changing, next-level, big-time guy at wide receiver, the 67-year-old and a five-time national champion for Alabama, six times overall, tends to always find his way to the Sunshine State of Florida when it comes down to getting a receiver. Never fails. It started off in 2012. You pull Amari Cooper from Miami Northwestern High School, four-star guy, career all-time leader in receptions, yards, and touchdowns for the Crimson Tide. He's right now in the National Football League, was a first-round pick, number four overall, in the 2015 venue to the Oakland Raiders. He's right now playing for the Dallas Cowboys. From there, you look at Calvin Ridley. You get him from Monarch High School, Coconut Creek, Florida, five-star guy, was a 1,000-yard receiver as a freshman, first team all SEC, freshman All-American type player. And though he didn't have the numbers he wanted to have as a junior, both his freshman year and his junior year, helped Alabama win a national championship. Calvin Ridley, first round pick in the 2018 venue, number 26 overall to those Atlanta Falcons. And now currently, you got Jerry Jeudy, Deerfield Beach High School, five-star guy, 1,315 yards a season ago, 14 touchdowns off 68 catches. And here's a guy that, once again, projected top five pick in the upcoming draft. So it's been a proven fact. Alabama goes down to Florida. Nick Saban getting quality big player receivers. Probably the only guy from the Florida area that did not pan out for Alabama was Chris Black. You got him in 2012 out of Jacksonville, Florida. And it was not because of the fact that Black wasn't good. Five-star, highly talented, big-time speed, big-time playmaking ability, great hands. It was just the injury bug. Injuries robbed Alabama fans of Chris Black. Injuries took him from us. But aside from him, Bama has had success with Floridians at wide receiver coming to Alabama. But the question is Xavier Williams the next heir to the throne? Is Xavier Williams the next big-time star? When I look at Ziggy out of Chaminade, Madonna Prep, Hollywood, Florida, here's a guy that took his high school, or helped his high school, helped his prep school, I should say, get to back-to-back Class 3A state championship games in 2016 and 2017. Of course, the school won the state title in 2017. Here's a guy that for his career, we're looking at 67 catches, 1,647 yards, and 21 touchdown receptions. In the 8A game, Xavier Williams had a couple of catches showed out there, including a 22-yard touchdown reception from one Mac Jones. So he's a speedy guy. He's got size at 6'1", 195 pounds. He's got strong hands. And despite the fact that Jalen Waddle was the breakout guy from a 2018 class, Xavier Williams can do some things, people. I mean, here's a guy that, when he ran scout team a season ago, he simulated some of the better wide receivers in the country and given Alabama's defense a quality look at some of the guys that they would face down the road. So he's quality talent. The difference is when you look at Amari Cooper and Calvin Ridley, it took an injury to propel both of those guys to the forefront, right? For Amari Cooper in 2012, it took the injuries to Chris Black and DeAndre White blowing out his knee against Ole Miss to propel Amari Cooper. Then when you look at Calvin Ridley, it took a rotator cuff injury to Robert Foster in 2015 to promote or propel Ridley up there. The difference with Williams is he's got to break through the competition, because he's competing against a true freshman and John Metchie from Brampton, Canada. I call him Calvin Ridley's Canadian twin, and I'm not backing off that. So you're competing against John Metchie, Tyrell Shavers at 6'6", 205 pounds out of Lewisville, Texas, and people are just waiting for him to break out. Some call him a poor man's version of Julio Jones. I call him a poor man's version of Cam Sims, but that's besides the point. They're waiting for Tyrell to break out. And then last but not least, Slade Bolden, the wild card, the athlete from the 2018 class, the Gatorade Player of the Year for the state of Louisiana. So you got all those three guys battling along with Xavier Williams to try to be that fifth wide receiver to emerge to join the likes of Jeudy, Ruggs, Smitty, and Jalen Waddle. So that's the question for Xavier Williams. Can he break through the clutter and be that fifth guy? Because going back to the spring game, a lot of people are high on John Metchie, not just me. The young man, five catches for 133 yards, was the Dixie Howell Memorial Most Valuable Player, MVP of that game. So while the conversation is on Metchie and people are high on Tyrell Shavers, got a couple of guys, Nevin Slade, Bolden. But can Xavier Williams press through the crowd, break through, and have a marquee year? And have marquee production, I should say. He's got the size, speedy wideout, has really improved in practice. According to Nick Saban, throughout the spring, he talked about how, you know, Ziggy has broken into that second tier of wide receivers. So he's going to get some playing time. He's going to get an opportunity to showcase his talent. But can he put himself in a situation to where he can make a significant marquee contribution and being that Florida guy, that Florida native on the rise to be a big-time star and a big-time playmaker, Xavier Williams? We'll see what he does. Had a great spring ball. Fall camp is coming. He's in 7-on-7 right now, in summer workouts right now. Fall camp is coming. I will keep my eyes on Ziggy to see, can he break through in the upcoming fall? It's going to take us to our final break here on In My Own Words. When we get back, folks, we got a special treat here for you. Former player joins the set. Big-time wide receiver who was a part of a national championship team in 2011. Who's the big-time wide receiver? Who can I be referring to? Check it out on the other side of this break. You don't want to miss it, folks. It's In My Own Words. What's up, college football fans? You can catch the show every Tuesday, Thursday, and Saturday. Subscribe to get all the news, notes, and information covering your Alabama Crimson Tide.